Good morning, class. For this week, we are going to tackle about grouping quadratic functions and analyzing the effects on its graph. Okay, so after going through this module, you are expected to grasp a quadratic function wherein we have a domain, range, intercepts, axis of symmetry, vertex, and the direction of the opening of the parabola, and analyzes the effects of changing the values of a, h, and k in the equation of y is equal to a times the square of x minus h plus k of a quadratic function on its graph. Okay? So for example, we have a graph like this one. So you are going to identify the domain, the range, the opening of the parabola, the vertex, and the axis of symmetry, x and y intercept. Okay? So therefore, to identify that, so let us have the given example. So for example, we have y is equal to negative 2 x squared. So the domain is all the set of all real numbers wherein the value of x, okay? So the value of x are all this real numbers. And the range is less than or equal to 0. Kasi narito siya and then going down or downward. The opening of the parabola is downward. Okay? So ito yung vertex natin, 0, 0. So therefore, yung range natin ay less than or equal to 0. The vertex, what is the axis of symmetry? So the axis of symmetry, we have x is equal to 0. So ito po yun. Okay? And then, the x-intercept is x is 0. Okay? And the y-intercept is 0. But then, wherein from here, going to the downward. Yun ang ating value ng y. Ano? Kasi ito yung x, ito yung y. Okay? Number 2. Given y is equal to 2x squared minus 4x plus 4. So first thing to do, transform it in y is equal to 8 times the quantity of square of x minus h plus k or the vertex form. So therefore, y is equal to 2 times the quantity of x minus 1 raised to the second power plus 2. Now, as you can see, the domain is set of all real numbers. Value ng y. Lahat pa rin ng real numbers. And the range R. Since narito yung vertex natin, and that is upward, the opening of the parabola. So therefore, y is equal to greater than or equal to 2. Ito yung ating 2, value ng y, then pataas siya. So, the vertex is 1 and 2. Diba? Ito yung x, then ito yung y axis. So, 1, 2, ito po yung vertex. Then, the axis of symmetry is 1, which is the value of x. Yun, diba? Axis of symmetry. And the x-intercept, we have no x-intercept. Kasi, diba, ito yung ating x. So, wala siyang x-intercept. Hindi siya dumaan dito sa ating x-axis. And then, the y-intercept is 4. Ito po yun. Wherein, kung 0 nga yung ating x, so therefore, we can get that the value of y is 4. Okay? So, yun. Diba, pag sinabi nating y-intercept, that is 0, y. Diba? Kung 0 ito yung x natin, so the value of y is 4. Substituting the value of x. Okay? So that's it. So once again, take note that to find the vertex in the standard form, we can use use the formula for H and K, wherein negative B is over 2A, then K is 4AC minus B squared over 4A. Take note of that, ha, to get the value of H and K. So therefore, in the function of y is equal to 2x minus 4, x plus 4, a is equal to 2, b is equal to negative 4, and c is 4. So substitute the values. So we have h is equal to 1. And then the value of k is 2. So therefore, the vertex is 1, 2. Okay? And to get the domain of the quadratic function, it is set of real numbers in the form of y is equal to a times the quantity of the square of x minus h plus k, wherein a is greater than 0. Then the range of the quadratic function is greater than or equal to k. If a is less than 0. Okay? Then the range of the quadratic function is less than or equal to k. And then, to get the value of a indicates the opening of the parabola. Okay? If it is upward, downward. Okay? If a is positive, then the parabola opens upward. Take note of that, ha? Then, if the value of A is negative, it opens downward. And take note that the value indicates the different forms of quadratic functions and its properties in the form of y is equal to x squared, so the vertex is 0, 0. Then, if y is equal to ax squared plus k, so the vertex is 0k. Ang value ng x ay 0, then the value of k is wherein the value of k here. Now, if we have like this one, okay, yung vertex form natin, so therefore, we have now the vertex as hk. And then in the standard form or general form here, so you are going to write it first to this vertex form to get the vertex as hk. Then, the axis of symmetry wherein the value of x. So, from here, so x is equal to 0, yung dalawa, kasi 0 ito. Then, this one, the value of x is h, kasi meron na tayong hk. And take note that the vertex of the parabola is the point of hk. It is the minimum point of the parabola if a is greater than 0 and maximum point of the parabola is a is less than 0. And to get the axis of symmetry, the vertical line x is equal to h. Take note of that, ha? And also divides that the parabola into two equal parts. Okay, yung axis of symmetry. The x-intercepts is determined by setting y as 0 and then solving for x, so you can get now the value of the x-intercept. So, on the other hand, the y-intercept is determined by setting x is equal to 0 and solve for y. So, therefore, for example, like this one, ax squared plus bx plus c, which has two distinct x-intercepts. B squared minus 4ac is greater than 0. Only one x-intercept. If b squared minus 4ac is equal to 0, so there are no x-intercept. Okay? No intercept kapag b squared minus 4ac is less than 0. Then, only one intercept kapag b squared minus 4ac is equal to 0. Okay? So, take note of that. Okay? So on your activity or worksheet, so we have a given table, so you are going to determine the domain, range, opening of the parabola, vertex, axis of symmetry, x and y intercept. Okay? So this time, let us have the given quadratic function graph, or the graph of a quadratic function. So we are going to determine the vertex, direction of the opening of the parabola, axis of symmetry, domain and range, and the intercepts of the given graph. So from here, as you can see, the vertex is at the point of 1, negative 4. Okay? So, positive 1, negative 4. Then, the opening of the parabola is upward. Okay? So, upward. And the vertex is a minimum point. Minimum point siya. Wherein, the axis of symmetry is, wherein the value of x is 1. Ito po yung axis of symmetry. So, axis of symmetry, if we divide the parabola into two equal parts. Then, the value of the domain is all real numbers. And the value of range, the value of y, is greater than or equal to negative 4. Kasi po, ang ating vertex ay negative 4. So, from here, then, since that is going upward, so yun po yung ating range. Then, the x-intercept. If we substitute the value of y on the original equation, we have negative 1, 0, and 3, 0. So as you can see in the graph, so ito po yung ating x-intercept. Then the y-intercept is we have 0, negative 3. So if we substitute the x as 0, so we have 0, negative 3. How about example number 2? So the vertex is negative 1, 4. So negative 1, 4. So ito po yun, ang vertex natin. Then opening of the parabola is downward. So the vertex is a maximum point. Maximum siya kasi narito sa taas. And then axis of symmetry is x is equal to negative 1. And the domains are all set of real numbers. And the value of range is less than or equal to 4. So, ito po yun. Since siya ay pababa, so dito yung ating range. Narito na. So, positive 4. Then, the x-intercept is we have negative 3, 0 and 1, 0. How about the y-intercept? We have 0, 3. Sa substitute nyo lang yung value ng x as 0 to get the y-intercept. Okay? And notice how vertex plays an important role in determining the characteristics of the graph of a function. Even without the graph and you know that the vertex you can identify on the direction of the opening of the parabola wherein the axis of symmetry, domain and range, and the intercepts of the given graph. Okay? Another example. This time, meron na tayong value ng h and k. Okay? So, yon, h and k na po siya. So, wherein, in the value of h and k, so these are the vertex, h and k. Then, the direction of the parabola, since a is less than 0, then it's offense downward. Okay? And then the axis of symmetry is negative 2 kasi yun siya ang value ng x natin ay negative 2 dun sa ating vertex. Then the domain of the quadratic functions is all real numbers. The range is, since it opens downward, so therefore, y is less than or equal to 7 or 7 and negative infinity. Then the x-intercept, intercept are 3, 0 and 1, 0. And the y-intercept is 0, 3. Okay? So, ganun lang po siya. Without graphing, so you can determine the vertex, the direction of the parabola, axis of symmetry, domain, range, and the intercepts of the quadratic functions. Okay? Another one. Now, as you can see here, okay? So, we are going to sketch the graph of the function. So, the vertex are negative 2 and 3. Diba? 2 and 3. Yung ating vertex. Since it A is greater than 0, so the graph opens upward. And the value of H tells the horizontal movement of the graph since H is equal to 2. Diba? H is equal to 2. Then the graph moves 2 units to the right. The value of K tells the vertical movement of the graph since K is equal to 3. And the graph moves 3 units upward. So therefore, the graph of Y is equals the quantity or the square of X minus 2 plus 3 is the graph of Y is equal to X square move by 2 units to the right and 3 units upward. So, yun yung kanyang trend. And that is opening upward and the vertex is 0. Okay? And wherein, since the vertex is 2, 0, so therefore, the axis of symmetry is 2. The value of x is 2. Another one. For the equation, y is equal to negative x plus 2 raised to the plus 3 raised to the second power plus 4. So the value of h is negative 3 and the value of k is 4. So therefore, ang ating vertex ay negative 3, 4. The axis of symmetry is negative 3. And since a is equal or less than 0, kasi yung ating a ay negative 1, so the graph opens downward. Diba? Okay? Number 3. Or another example. We have y is equal to x squared minus 6x plus 5 in the standard form. Okay? So, if we write it in the vertex form, we have y is equal to the square of x minus 3 plus 4. So, the value of a is 1, h is 3, and then k is negative 4. So, the graph opens upward kasi more than 0. A is greater than 0 kasi negative, positive 1 siya, so upward siya. And the trend is move 3 units to the right and 4 units down. So the opening is upward and then the axis of symmetry is positive 3. Then another one, we have negative y is equal to 2x squared minus 4x minus 3. So therefore, ito yung ating vertex form. So the value of a is equal to 2. So more than, ano siya, greater than 0. So siya ay upward. Upward siya, di ba? And then the vertex is 1, negative 5. So 1, negative 5, h and k. Then the axis of symmetry is 1. Okay? Another one. How if we have a given values? Okay? So, this time, ang atin namang kukunin ay equation. Okay? So, we have the table here, x and y. So, negative 1, 0. So, ito yung trend niya. Okay? So, select, you are going to select 3 ordered pairs. So, negative 1, 0, 0, negative 1, 1, negative 4. So, in the equation number 1, from using the standard form or quadratic equation, we have, diba ito y? So, 0 yung ating y, substitute lang natin. So we have A is equal to negative 1 square plus B, negative 1, then C. Okay, so yun yung ating equation number 1. And then for equation number 2, 0, negative 1 ang gagamitin natin. So we have negative 1 equals A times 0 square plus B times 0 plus Z. And then for 1, negative 4, we have negative 4 as the value of y. Then the value of x is 1. So we have a times 1 square plus b1 times 1 plus c. Okay. Now, atin natin siyang si-simplify. So for the values of a, b, and c on the system of linear equation, okay, from equation number 2, c is equal to negative 1. Diba? Kasi 0 na to eh. Diba? 0 na yon. So, C is equal to 1. Then, substitute the value of C to equation number 1. So, kung ito yung negative 1, so therefore, we can have as the value of B. So, the value of B is A minus 1. Then, substitute the value of B and C to the equation number 3. Dito na sa equation number 3. So, on the equation number 3, solve for A. So, the value of A is negative 1. So, therefore, we can say that A is equal to negative 1, B is equal to 2, negative 2, and C is equal to negative 3. Using the system of linear equation. Okay? So, kapag ang given natin ay given table, you can determine the value of A, B, and C. Okay? So, that's all. And thank you.